Welcome one more time, students. Today is a new day. Today we have something new. I'm gonna show you here your classroom presentation tool. You know, remember the previous class, the previous lesson, I think we're working on the unit number 4, or we're finishing, right? The unit number 4. So I'm gonna show you something here. We're talking, we're learning about some topics, right? We did all of this, right? We finished talking, working on this. The previous class we did this activity. We finished the activity, the page number 48. And now we are on the unit number 5, right? We are in the unit number 5. So I'm gonna show you this, the unit number 5. We did this the previous class, right? I think we work until this part. We were talking about the use of theirs. Do you remember? We were using there's a sandwich, there are some noodles, there are a lot of things to eat, there aren't any milkshakes, are there any pancakes? No? There's some juice, there's a lot of ketchup, no? Estuvimos trabajando el uso de los countables y los uncountables, right, students? Decíamos que en inglés hay algunos sustantivos que son contables y otros que son incontables, ¿verdad? Y teníamos algunas palabritas que se usaban, ¿no? Por lo general, el some tenía la característica de poder usarse tanto para los countables y para los uncountables, ¿no? A diferencia del a, que solamente se usa para los countables, ¿ya? De igual manera, a lot of. ¿Cuál es la diferencia? Que los non-count no tienen forma plural. Dice, there is some juice. Pero en, si es un countable, tienes que utilizar are. There are some noodles, for example. ¿No? Luego indicamos que el aren't, sorry, cuando yo hago una oración negative, utilizo any. There aren't any. There isn't any. ¿Verdad? For example, in question también siempre voy a utilizar any. Are there any pancakes? Is there any water? ¿Ya? Entonces recuerda, la estructura de los non-counts, de los uncountables, va a estar siempre en singular, ¿verdad? O sea, utilizo is o isn't. Mientras que para los countables puedo utilizar is o también puedo usar are, ¿ya? Pero a diferencia que en el non-count, nunca voy a utilizar are. Pues. Para los non-count, siempre voy a utilizar is. ¿Ya? Ok. Then, for example, here we have this part that says, activity 4, draw and ask. For example, is there any salad in your refrigerator? Say, no, there isn't. Are there any eggs in your refrigerator? Yes, there are. There are 6. No? I'm gonna ask here, for example, are there any burgers? No? Are there any burgers in your refrigerator? You can say, yes, there are. No, there are. No? I can ask, is there a soup or is there any soup in your refrigerator? You can say, yes, there is, no, there is, no? Is there any, are there any bananas in your refrigerator? Yes, there are, no, there are. ¿Ya? Si te das cuenta, si te pregunta con is, respondes con is. Si te pregunta con are, respondes con are, ¿no? Como en este caso dice, is there any salad? Pregunta con is. Responde, no, there isn't. Y la siguiente dice, Are there any eggs in your refrigerator? Responde con are. Yes, there are. ¿Ve? ¿Te diste cuenta? Entonces, de esta manera. ¿Ok? Ya, I'm gonna do this. Now, students, let's continue to the next part. Oh, no, my God. No worry, porque students book. Seguimos en el students book, ¿ok? And let's go to this part. Here we have a reading. ¿Ok? It says, lesson 3, reading. Activity 1, look at the words, listen and repeat. Okay, look at these words. We have some words you're going to listen and repeat. So, pay attention.
Cups.
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 Plates.
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 Bowls.
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 Straws.
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 Bottles.
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 Glass.
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 Glass. Okay. Well, students, in this part, you can see some things, right? Oh, what is all of this? What do you think? What are they? Do you have an idea? What says on this part? It says plastic bottles in Cibeles Fountain, Madrid, Spain. Oh my God, plastic bottles. Are they good for the environment? I think they contaminate, right? The plastic bottles, they contaminate the environment.
Intendation, yeah? English
teacher. Oh, why not you reading intendation, hilariation? No, yeah? You know, what are these, Hilar? They are bottles. Yes or no? They are bottles. Yeah? And they contaminate. Yes? They contaminate. Okay? And here in this part says plastic. Plastic bottles. Right? So, here we have a vocabulary that talks about cups. What are cups? What are plates? What are bowls? What are straws? What are bottles? What is glass? No, for example, cups, tazas, right? Plates, platos. Bowls, no, tazoncitos o platitos para sopita, bowls, no. What are straws? Eso que te gusta cuando pides tu pulpín, ¿no? Agarras tu straw. Ok, straw. Ajá. Milagros dice, no, el pulpín le gusta a Matías. Ok, ya, yeah, el pulpín de Matías. Ok, what are bottles? These are bottles. Aquí están los bottles. Ok. And finally, what is glass? El vaso, pues, ¿no? Donde tomas tu refresco. Glass. Yeah, and now it says here, no, where does plastic garbage in the ocean come from? Listen and read. You know, how do the garbage, do you remember what is garbage? Basura, right? Garbage. Where does plastic garbage in the ocean come from? O sea, ¿de dónde proviene? It says, listen and read, okay? You're gonna listen and you're gonna read about this. That this is something really important, right? To know. It's really important to protect the environment. Yeah, so pay attention, let's read.
There's a lot of garbage in the ocean. It's a big problem for the fish and other animals that live in the ocean, and for us. There are
recording. Remember, according to the recording, now we did this activity, right? We say, when we buy food and drinks, we also buy garbage. Lots of bottles go into the ocean after we use them. So don't ask your parents to buy a bottle of water. Take an old bottle with you. You don't need a straw to drink. And talk to your friends about the problem, because this is a big problem, students, no? The planet is dying, the ocean is contaminated, it's dirty, yeah? Okay, now, let's see, I think now we must continue, let me see, let me check. Okay, let's do this part, yeah? Let's go to this part. the grammar part. What's the grammar part about? Grammar lesson 4, activity 1, listen and read. So pay attention. I'm going to play the listening and you're going to read.
Can I have a glass of water, please? Can I have a bottle of juice, please? Can I have a bowl of rice, please? Can I have a plate of pasta, please? Can I have a slice of bread, please? Can I have a bag of grapes, please?
Okay. In this part, students, we're talking about this, no? The presentation. A glass of, a bottle of, a bowl of, a plate of, a slice of, a bag of. Okay? So, when you ask, can I have a glass of water, for example, estás pidiendo, ¿verdad? Can I have, me puedes traer, o puedo tener, ¿no? Me puedes traer una botella con agua, por favor. ¿No? Can I have a glass of water, please? Esta traducción, chicos, no hay que tomarlo de manera literal, ¿no? Alguno me puede decir, pero teacher, esto, have es tener. Y si usted dice ahorita, can I have, está diciendo, me puede traer, ¿no? No sería can you bring me, ¿no? Podría ser, pero normalmente esa es una expresión que se usa cuando tú pides algo, ¿no? Por ejemplo, vas a un restaurante y en ese restaurante, quieres hacer un pedido, quieres pedir, no sé, una bebida, algún alimento. Entonces, la forma correcta es decir, can I have, ¿no? Can I have a glass of water, please? ¿No? ¿Me puede traer un vaso con agua, please? ¿No? For example, if you see the next part says, ¿no? Can I have a bottle of juice, please? ¿Me puedes traer una botella de jugo, por favor, no? Can I have a bowl of rice? Remember, bowl es como un tazoncito, un bowl, ¿verdad? O también son esos platitos honditos en los cuales te sirven, pues, a veces las sopitas, son bowls, ¿no? Okay. Can I have a bowl of rice, please? Can I have a plate of pasta? You know plate, right? El plato. Can I have a plate of pasta, please? Entonces, puedes decir, ¿me puedes traer, no? Un plato de pasta, please, no? Can I have a slice? What is a slice? A slice es un trozo, un pedazo. For example, de una torta, ¿no? ¿Qué es lo que sale? Lo cortas y sale un slice, ¿no? ¿Verdad? De un molde de pastel, de torta, por ejemplo, ¿no? Lo mismo sucede a veces con el pan. Te compras el pan de molde y el pan de molde viene en slices, slice. ¿Ok? ¿Ya? For example, for what? For pizza, de la pizza también, ¿no? You cut the pizza and you get a slice. Obtienes un slice. ¿Ya? Now, can I have a bag of grapes? What is a bag? A bag es una bolsa, pues, ¿no? Una bolsa, un paquete. A bag of grapes. Okay? So just don't forget, a glass of, a bottle of, a bowl of, a plate of, a slice of, a bag of. Yeah? So now, let's go to the next part. It says, make sentences. Okay, you're gonna make sentences on this part. On what way? One moment, I'm gonna do something. Yeah. That's it. That's it. Now, for example, in this part, my goodness, I'm going to change this. Oh, my God. One moment. Something is wrong here. Yeah. That's it. Yeah. For example, it says, now make sentences. I bottle soda, please. Voy a formar horas o voy a formar una pregunta, ¿verdad? ¿De qué manera? No te olvides. ¿Cómo realizo mi pregunta? Can I have? Así tengo que empezar sí o sí. ¿Ve? Entonces aquí al I le estoy añadiendo can I have, ¿verdad? Luego, ¿qué es lo que voy a pedir? A bottle, ¿verdad? a bottle of. Recuerda que esto también se compone de esta manera, ¿verdad? Diciendo a bottle of. Ahí está. A bottle of. Can I have a bottle of soda, please? Ahí está. No, yo tengo soda, que es la gaseosa, ¿verdad? Puedo decir, can I have a bottle of soda? Can I have a bottle of juice? Etcétera. Y el please, please se mantiene. ¿Ya? Number two. ¿Cuál será the correct way? ¿Cuál será la forma correcta en el number two? What do you think? Vamos, let's think. ¿Cómo se empieza todas las preguntas? ¿De qué manera? Vamos, ¿de qué manera inicio las preguntas? Allí está, de color red, está marcada.
I can.
Okay.
Can I?
Can I? Ok, pero en este caso me pide que use I o qué pronombre. Can
we.
Very good. Can we.
Can we have.
This milk.
What else? Can we have.
Two.
Two.
Glasses.
Two glasses.
Milk.
Ok, pero hay una estructura of para milk. Esas palabritas.
Of milk.
Oh, yeah, ¿no? A bottle of, a glass of, ¿no? A bottle of, two glasses of, don't forget. ¿Ya? Can we have two glasses of what? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más está ahí en la pregunta? Después de glasses, ¿qué tengo que buscar? Milk, that's right. Can we have two glasses of milk? What else?
Please.
Please.
Please. Excellent. That's the correct way. Yeah? Now let's work on number. Well, in this part, students, we have here the answer. In number one, we say, can I have a bottle of soda, please? Number two, can we have two glasses of milk, please? Number three, can I have a slice of bread, please? Number four, can I have a bowl of soup, please? Number five, can we have a bag of tomatoes, please? Number six, can I have a plate of noodles, please? No? And here we match a glass of mango juice, a glass of water, a slice of pizza, a slice of cake, a bottle of ketchup, a bowl of noodles, a bowl of ice cream. Number five, a plate of meat, a plate of fries. And number six, a bag of apples, a bag of candy, and a bag of potatoes. Right here we have the question, for example, not between two people. Can I help you? Yes. Can I have a bowl of pasta, please? And a glass of pineapple juice? Yes, of course. Here you are. Thank you. Right? This is a common conversation in a restaurant, ¿no? Una conversación en un restaurant. Viene el waiter. ¿Te puedo ayudar? Sí, ¿no? Can I have a bowl of pasta, please? ¿No? ¿Me puede traer a bowl of pasta? And a glass of pineapple juice, ¿no? Jugo de pineapple. Yes, of course. Here you are. Le trae el pedido and you say, thank you. And that's all. Okay. Now, well, students, we must stop here. Esta semana no hay homework. I just want to say that's all for today. Thank you very much and see you the next class. Bye-bye, students. Take care. See you.